Hello everyone, how you doing? This is going off of the other day when I got asked to do a pet peeve, everything, and I end up just going online seeing what people's pet peeves are, okay? And I ended up getting this thing from Huffington Post, okay, which I'll leave it in the description below. And it's 76 incredibly accurate pet peeves that will drive you nuts. That drives me nuts, yeah, okay? Using words and then periods to emphasize things. That definitely is a small pet peeve of mine. Anyways, let's get right into it. And let me know in the comments below what your pet peeve is. If you have any, let alone green with any of these. And if you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and hit the subscribe button and the notification bell, because I put out videos every week, close to every day now, and I don't want you to miss out on things. Okay, anyways, let's get right into it. Loud chewing or people chewing with their mouths open. Yeah, that's annoying, especially when kids do it on purpose. Like, they know they should be doing it. Like, I'm talking about like 5-6-year-olds. Yeah, come on. If they don't know how to chew the mouths closed, their parents aren't doing their job, okay? I know a kid who's not even a year old that knows how to chew with her mouth closed, okay? So, a 5-year-old doesn't know how to do it, okay, come on. And it's really, really annoying when adults do it. And I'm like, I like seafood, but you're ruining it for me now, okay? Seriously. And if I could see the back of your throat, like, chomping too, oh my gosh. I have told people in the past that, dude, I could see food in your teeth. I don't want to see food in your teeth when you're eating, okay? Not cool. Two, when people are late or make me run late because I'm waiting for them. Yes! It's so true. Granted, I'm one of those people too. I like to be there like 15 minutes beforehand or more if I can. Otherwise, I feel like I'm late. But like actually being late because of someone else is really annoying. Especially when they say, okay, when people tell me, okay, I'm ready whenever you are. And I go, okay, I'm ready, let's go. And then they're like, seriously, now this second, not a minute from now? What the hell? Right. And it's one of those things where, like, when people are late and they don't tell me that they're going to run late, that really pisses me off. I'm like, at least tell me. Come on. Three, people who are chronically late. A one-off, I mean, can maybe understand, but it's incredibly rude to think that your time is more valuable than the 15, 30 minutes you're making me wait. Okay, so that kind of go with when people are late. Yeah, the whole thing, like, yeah, you say, okay, the show starts at 2 o'clock, and they show 15, 20 minutes later, half an hour, and it's like when the actual movie, you go to a movie, whatever, and they show up that time, of like when the movie actually starts, or it's 15 minutes, and that really annoying, okay? When I was selling tickets at a movie theater, it didn't really bother me because it was their time, and I was getting paid either which way. But, like, people saying, oh, wait for me. Don't go in the movie theater until I show up. I'm like, I might do that until, like, 5 minutes before the actual movie starts. But otherwise, I'm like, no, I'm not going to do that. I'll save you a seat if I can. People who scuff their feet as they walk down the street, especially if they're wearing Uggs. Sometimes shoes are like that, you know, but if they're, like, moving their feet or scraping the ground. Yeah, I can see that, especially if it's all the time. Ugh, my gosh. People smoking e-cigarettes around non-smokers. Smoking. For the most part, yes, I agree with that. Totally. But it's one of those things where being an e-cigarette or an actual cigarette, what gets me is when they have a big puff and they blow it right into your face or in a general area, you don't want them to do it. It's common courtesy to when you have a big smoke you're gonna put your head away from people, like opposite direction, not at them, okay? That's what gets me. And with the e-cigarettes, smokers, they tend to are able to get a lot more smoke out, and it makes me think they're a whole city and there's smog and everything. And that's really annoying. That gets me, especially if it's not, I'm not in a group of people who have those. Just the overall of like seeing it around other people bugs me. People who chew gum loudly and attempt to blow bubbles in fine quarters. A lot of people I've seen don't tend to blow bubbles, but the chewing gum loudly, it's like smacking. It's kind of like it goes with food. So I don't want to see it. And if you have to do that, you got too big of a piece of gum. I know there's some gums that are huge. Just take half of it and chew it that way. The feel of chalk. Some of you guys that are watching this might not know what chalk is, but especially for classrooms and everything, I don't mind the feel of chalk. And I think it's because I don't use it that often. Like, chalk, whatever. And it never really bothered me on it in general. People who walk into the subway and stand right in front of the door. My whole thing is when people walk into a room and just stand there, and they know for a fact that there's a few other people following them. Like, come on, you know? And it's one of those things where, even just into a house, even, I'm like, you guys, there's more of the house than the front room, a few first 5 feet. Okay, you're not going into an elevator. Walk. And I've actually made mention of it, of people, and even made myself move around them, like, and say, oh, you guys, there's more to the house. And we're like, I'll also go, oh, look, a kitchen. I could go in here. You know, I'm like, oh, I'm free. I'm not confined or stuck in the doorway. I've literally said stuff like that to people. Oh, don't just stop. Seriously. And like, especially when I open the front door and they go, come on in. And they take 3 steps and there's a few other people behind them. I'm like, move, go forward, come on, keep going. You could do it. I see you walk a few feet. You could walk a few more. Let's go. People who don't cover their mouths when they cough. This is annoying. 8, 9-year-olds, come on, you could do it. But when they're like 80s, oh my gosh. I don't want your dying disease. Come on. Everyone's gonna die, okay? But yeah, it's just that gets me. Like, I cover it, you use your hand, or I do like in my elbow, okay? I do that a lot. Even when I sneeze, I do that. It's like, come on. People who discuss being on a diet while you're in the middle of eating something unhealthy. Gosh, you guys. I can see this, how people can really get mad at that. And I've had people do it to me before. Not that often, though. And I'm like, even when you're like, right, burger, about to bite into it, and you're like, I'm on a diet. I'm like, I'm on a diet too. It's called eating food, giving my body nutrition of some sort. Okay, some greasy food might not be the best out there, but at least I'm putting something in my face, unlike you, who's only drinking water. Okay. Next one. People who say ew to the food on your plate. I've had this happen so many times, and I've actually used it against people who've done it to me. And like they put pretty much almost the exact same thing on my pl on their plate as I do it on mine, and go over and I emphasize it because they go, ew. I go into their face and go, ew, my God. Yeah, I know, emphasize. That's an example, okay? I just go to their face and I do it. And I'm like, and I've actually had someone go, what was that for? And I go, I did exactly what you did. What's wrong? Why are you mad at me? Stuff like that. Just to emphasize, like, I know I overreacted, but it was to prove a point of what they were doing. And, and I've actually, on other occasions with the exact same people, go, "What do you think of my food? Ew, right? Oh, look at what you got." Just to make sure they know not to do that around me. Without actually saying, me saying to them, "Please don't do that." Okay. People who eat food off your plate without asking first. There's a few occasions to where I'm fine with it, but it's one of those things to where they ordered what they got, if they ordered at all, or on top of what I got. Like, I got this for me. Excuse me. If I didn't say, "Hey, let's share something," then this is for me. I've actually snapped people's hands before. They take a fry and I slap it multiple times even, because I'm not doing it hard. I'm like, "Stab it." And like, "Why are you hitting my hand? Why are you eating my fries? You didn't ask." And yeah, the people stopped. I stopped ordering food around them, even to at that too. When people ask if they can have some of your food as they grab the food off your plate, that's another thing. "Oh, can I have this fry?" I'll be like, "No." And sometimes I'll be like, slap their hands, like, "No, you can't have it. Go order your food, you're waiting for your food, fries, whoever, get it, There have been times to where they would take a fry off my plate, and then they get their food, and I'd take a fry off their plate, and they go, "What was that for?" I'd be like, "You ate a fry off of my plate." So it's every free game pretty much when you get your food and I grab it. Okay, seriously. People who use redundant hashtags on Instagram, like hashtag me, hashtag human, hashtag girl, hashtag selfie. I tend to not follow people who do that to begin with. And if people do that, I tend to not pay attention to the comments because I'm just looking at the pictures. That's it. People who say "no offense" as if it downplays anything insulting that they say. When I was younger, sometimes it actually did downplay it a little bit, but it's still, even if they didn't say "no offense" and then proceed to whatever they're going to say, it still hurts. People who say "literally" when they mean is not literal. Like, literally almost died by a car and was hit a man. And there was standing on the sidewalk, and a car just went really fast as it went the corner. Yeah. I get it why people say that. They weren't paying attention and got scared. But yeah, no. Gosh. Like, literally, oh my god. People who woo when their favorite song comes on. I do that. Like, I haven't heard a song, particular song in a while and go, "Ooh, I like this." But I continue with "woo" with, "I like this song." And I turn out the up the volume. I don't do it all the time, but like people do song after song after song every day, daily. That gets annoying. Hearing people bite their nails. I don't hear people, but I see my husband do it, and I'm like, "Let me give you a nail clipper." He's like, "It's a hangnail. Let me give you nail clippers." Ooh, get that. And so that is annoying. And he gives me a response with, "I've been doing this since I was childhood." I'm like, "I don't care. Here's a freaking nail clipper." People that clip their nails at work while sitting at their desk. If they're loud about it and a nuisance, yeah, definitely. But of course, I never really done it or seen it. People do it a lot at the jobs I'm doing it. I've done because last few times it dealt with food, and yeah, if I saw that, I'd be like, "Oh, you're going home. Go leave. Clock out. Seriously, go away from the food." Seriously, I don't want to find out your nail that you clipped off into someone's food. Ugh. When groups of people take up an entire side of the street, move. Well, if they're not walking, yeah. Sometimes seeing a whole group of people and you're going against the crowd, you're going to. Group people and you and like this, yeah, it can. But like if they just standing there, I've actually a few times raised my voice, kind of talking to myself or someone else, like, and say, "Oh boy, I wish there was a way for me to get around all these people without having to go onto the street. Boy, I wish people would move. And usually I get looks with the whole thing, like, what's the problem with this? And with this person, I'm like, hey, how you doing? I need to get by. Bye. Bye, Felicia. People who walk slowly or stop suddenly in the middle of the sidewalk. Yeah, I can see that. I've had that problem before. But that's why you don't walk that closely behind them. So you don't run into them or anything. People who text, like, they're G-catching, sending OMG, then how did you know, then LOL within seconds. Yeah, that I've had that happen before. I'm like, let me talk. Gosh. Line cutters. There's social rules you must follow. Yeah, line cutters. It's one of those things where, like, I had it a couple weeks ago. One person in front of me was talking to the person behind me, and I ended up getting out of the way, and the person in front of me was not paying attention to the line that it was moving, so I went in front of them. I'm like, if you're not paying attention, people are going to go around you and go ahead. So, pay attention. People who don't know how to get through airport security efficiently. It's been 15 years. You know, you have to take off your shoes. You can't have liquids or so much. And get your computer out of your bag. Well, here's the thing. If you see people, if you know people that go decently amount times. Like me, I've gone to airports and flown a few times. I know to take my shoes off and all this other stuff. But if you got someone who's never flown ever in their life, it's one of those things you got to look and see what other people are doing. I'm like, oh, I'm supposed to do that? Okay, whatever. Do it. Honestly, pay attention to your surroundings. People who stand on the left side of an escalator, right is for standing, left is for walking. Well, if you're going on an escalator, people are going to stand, no matter what. Now, it's one of those things to where if it's one of those flat ones and it helps you move, I like to use those to get to a place faster by walking. So yes, in this case, definitely, right is for standing, left is for walking, for the direction it's going. So do that seriously, you guys. When you let a car cut in front of you and they don't wave or to thank you. Some people don't know how to do that. Legitimately, like, especially on highways, when you let, I see a lot of truck drivers do this to where they put on brakes, tap it, brakes, and say, thank you. Misspelled signs. I think this also goes with staying on the right side, yet it's pointed to the left. Misspelling my name when it's right there in the email staring at in your face. For me, it wasn't with the email. It's more of, my name is Sarah, as you could guess, with an H. I'm fine with people not putting the H at the end, because there's that way too. But, like, spelling it S-H-A-R-A, what? Shara? What? Or putting S-A-H-A-R-R-A. I'm like, I've actually written down, this is how you spell it. This is not how you ways you spell it. Don't do those ways. Do this way. Seriously. Simple names. Okay. When dog owners leave their dog's poop. Poop on the sidewalk. I keep that all the time everywhere. It is annoying. I don't do that. Slow cashiers. Depends. Like, is it their first day? How long has that cashier been there? If they've been there for a while and they've had experience with cashiering? Yeah, I've known someone who's had an experience cashiering over a year and they work somewhere else that deals with cashiering and they're slow. I'm like, come on. Saying, let's make plans and actually surprised when I try to follow and make actual plans. I've actually had that happen. And they're like, what? Really? I'm like, yeah, I'll be there at this place at this time. Okay. And they don't show up. And they're like, oh. And they try to make up excuse why they didn't show up and they don't have a real one. Online stores that charge for shipping. That doesn't bother me. I actually expect shipping charges. But if stores don't have shipping charges, I'm like, oh, cool. More reason for me to go shopping with them. There's a lot of places to where if you do, so you have to buy like $25 or even $50 or more to, I see it, $25, $50, $75, and $100. So, but a little bit here and there in between those. But you have to buy X amount of items from their store before you get free shipping type of thing. Food that only pretends to be organic. Yeah, they use artificial coloring or something like that. There's something about it like that. That's like one little detail that makes it not organic. Yeah. When people who don't see age or race. For me, I have a hard time seeing the age of someone. It could be like 10, 15 years really difference. But like it's one of those things, that's one of the first things you see with the color of the skin. You might skip over that. It's like, oh, okay, this person is like white, or this person's Latino descent, or they're black, whoever, they're kind of brown, you know, whatever. You're like, okay, that's the like first thing you notice. The small detail like that. But like, really, you don't see it, like, you see it. Gluten-free fanatics who have no medical justification to avoid gluten. For me, it's only if they're over the top with it. It's like, I don't eat gluten. Do you have a medical condition in it? No, I just don't want to eat it. I'm like, okay, whatever. Subway pole huggers. I never experienced things like this at all. People who say something will give you all the feels. I rarely hear anybody say that something like that, personally. People who talk over you when you're clearly still in the middle of the sentence. I've had that happen multiple occasions from people I personally know. And it gets to the point to where I'm like, clearly I'm not important enough to finish what I'm talking about. So I let my mind forget what I was talking about and listen to them. And they go, oh, and they go, once I finish, like, oh, I'm so sorry. What were you talking about? And I end up saying, I don't remember. You interrupted me. You know, clearly it's not important enough for you to pay attention to or wait for me to finish what I was saying. When people say on accident, it's by accident. I see how people get annoyed with that. Passive-aggressive behavior. If you have something you want to say, just say it. Yeah, sometimes it's really annoying. Yeah, it really is. When you can hear someone eating their cereal. Food is crunchy, okay? It's also part of the whole thing of make sure your mouth's closed. Strangers on subway who choose to listen to the music through the speakers instead of the headphones. Yeah. Definitely annoying on that. When you're running after the bus, you look all guys with the bus driver in the rear view mirror and they're so drive straight past you. Yeah, I have never experienced something like that, but I can see how people can definitely be annoyed by that. When you open the door for someone and not only do they not thank you, they also glide straight past you. As if people should open doors for them. Yeah, I go past people, but I also, like, I kind of slide sometimes, but I also say thank you, no matter what. Miss pluralized last names on holiday cards. Do not expect me to keep, read, or even acknowledge your card if you sign it the Greens. I can see people using, like, whatever the last name, because they're including everyone, especially if it's a large family, like 19 kids and counting. But I see how people get annoyed with it. I'm not annoyed with it, though. when people call Latinos Spanish. Most of us weren't born in Spain. I could definitely see that, be annoyed with. There's Spain, and then there's like from Mexico all the way down to the bottom of South Africa. I mean, America. South America. All that, like, Latinos right there. Latinos are a big group of people, okay? People who groom themselves on public transportation. Yeah. Do it at home. Give yourself some time, do it at home. Otherwise, don't do it. When people repeatedly hit the elevator button, I said they will make an elevator arrive sooner. Yeah, that's even with crosswalks. They keep pushing it. You know, that's annoying. And I'm guilty of doing something like that with the crosswalks. When people show or shove past you on the street and say, excuse you, I'm like, there was plenty of room, okay? Come on. This non-apology, I'm sorry you feel that way. I'm like, no, you don't. No, you don't. You don't. When people spend more time on their phone during dinner or brunch than they do with interacting with people present at the table. Yeah, that's why there's a whole thing of people putting their phones in a basket, everyone in the same basket, so you talk to people, you know. Especially if you're there with the people and they all came together and it's like a bunch of different people who just sat down, then you have no don't know who they are. That's so different. People who sing out loud out of nowhere, crowd of people. I've heard people like that. It really is. The reply all that asks to be taken off an email thread. Oh, you're getting too many irrelevant emails? Is that getting annoying? So now you're putting one more on the damn chain thing. Now, here's the thing. I've had something like this on Twitter. People just randomly tagging me on things, and I'm like, guys, I didn't want to be here in the first place. You never even asked me if I want to be part of this, or a whole chain of things. I'm like, guys, don't put people on lists like that if they don't want to, if you never asked them to begin with. People who with an inflated sense of their own importance. Oh, yeah. They're Onision. Okay. That's all I got for that. People who say no problem or no worries in response to thank you. Probably a thing is in return and say, you're welcome. Okay, it really depends on what the whole thing is. Like, if it's a given, give or take. Like, you saw somebody come up and you'll hold the door and they say thank you. And holding the door for somebody, you'd be like, no problem, whatever. But, like, if you're generally interacting with someone, you notice, like, you're with, you know, then they do something. It's kind of hard to explain. It's a give or take, like, depending on what the whole situation is. If you see someone, like, in trouble, and you generally want to help, and you're like, it's really no problem or worry, then go ahead. I don't see how people are annoyed with that. I'm like, it's another thing, way, my perspective of saying you're welcome by saying no problem or no worries. Let me know your thoughts on that in the comments below. People who seal a Ziploc bag without removing the air first. Sometimes, you know. Okay, people who say myself instead of me or I. I guess how people can get annoyed with that. Adults who say yummy. They must be around children a lot. So think about that, y'all. Clapping at the end of a movie in a theater. I haven't seen too many people do that in a long time. The term touché. How could, really? People who, okay, this is how I see. People who don't like the word touche must be one of those people who they say something and they somebody else had a combat. Like, no, touche. Okay. They had too many people with a great combat come at them and everything, and that's why they don't like it. People who don't silence their phones when they play a game in public. You must not know. First thing that comes to mind is you don't know the type of work they're doing. But if they're actually in the game and their phone goes off, they probably don't care really, or they're waiting for someone to call them. You know, they want to hear it. Receiving emails from a colleague with my boss CC'd. I can see how people get annoyed with that. People who take selfies when there are other people around to take the picture. Like in a mirror in the bathroom, see another person, selfie in the bathroom. Taking selfies in the bathroom is annoying. When people say cool beans, I used to say cool beans. This makes me want to say cool beans more often now. When people go to irrational lengths to keep their middle name a secret. Why do you want to know what their middle name is? Granted, it's general curiosity, but I'm like, you don't need to know every single person's middle name. And not everyone has an actual middle name. People who say you should have been there when you clearly weren't there. It's just to emphasize, like, how crazy something was. I don't get sometimes how people could be annoyed with that. It would be a pet peeve. People who say, this is she, when someone is on the phone, asks for them, just say yes. Well, okay, here's the thing. I've had many people... ask on the phone, like, oh, is Sarah there? And I say, this is she. When I say this is she, that means you're talking to her. You know, when you say yes, it confuses people. I don't see how that's a pet peeve. I really don't. I really don't. Someone please just tell me in the comments section below. Companies that post 14 Instagrams in a row because they form a larger image on their account. No one goes to your account page. Yeah, I don't get how people could have like 6 or 9 photos that create one photo. I'm like, more photos you put on, more times will not make that picture. Seriously. People who abbreviate things that they don't need to be shortened. Yeah, I can see that. Like, the word U for the letter U. I can see how people get annoyed with that. I've actually had a try to have a conversation with this one guy who ended up starting doing that more and more. And ended up confusing the crap out of me, what he was trying to say. And with 4 different responses back to this guy, I'd be like, dude, I have no clue what you're talking about. Please write better. Like, I could do the short abbreviations with, like, the number 2 for any form of 2s, okay? The letter B for the word B-E, okay? But it's one of those things to where if I can't follow it, I'll be like, is this what you're trying to say? And then respond back with something different. I'm like, I'm sorry, what are you trying to say? It's kind of like when someone's, like, mumbles a lot and they're all over the place when they're talking. And I'm like... I'm sorry, first of all, speak louder, and 2, what the fuck are you talking about? Seriously, I stopped talking to people, no matter what. Like, I even met this guy in person, and how I met him in person versus what he says online, I'm like, 2 different people, seriously. I'm like, okay, I'm done with you, I'm completely done with you. Okay, colleagues that tell you they ate something really bad yesterday and should really stay at home. Just say you're taking a sick day. Nobody needs to hear the details. Yeah, sometimes I don't know when to stop on certain things, but, like, I'm not that bad. especially when it comes to work. People who say, you know, when you casually ask them how they're doing, A, I don't know. B, I probably don't care. It's one of those things where if you're at home and you usually do the same thing, okay. But if somebody asks how someone's doing, they want to know, like, have you been sick? Especially if you haven't talked in months, if not years. Like, you know how I've been. Like, if I haven't seen you in months, no, I haven't. No. Don't presume. That's presuming if you go, you know. That is a pet peeve of mine. Especially with people that I haven't seen in a long time. Public display of affection. I definitely can see how this is annoying. Because some of it annoys me. If it's a sloppy makeout, yeah, that's annoying. The casual arm over somebody or around someone's waist, that doesn't bother me. But if they have, like, a guy is over the girls and they bring her in and just start making out, and they do that every few seconds. Okay, yeah. Groping? No. You don't grope in public. Okay. No. People who send emails longer than 3 sections or 1 paragraph. Call or explain in person. Who has the time to read all that? Okay. If it's... I can see how people get annoyed with this. I really can. But it's for me, like, I don't do something like that because I'm not good with written words. I'm better off with doing something like this visually. Okay? I'm better able to explain things with words than I am with writing it down. I'm verbally better at it. I just feel like I can explain better. Even if I say exactly the same thing, written it down is more monotone than anything else. People who complain that they don't have time to read emails or tweets or know what's up because they're too busy, implying that you're a loser with too much spare time. Yeah, I see that. What gets me, what pisses me off and really becomes a pet peeve is when they say something like that, yet they spend more time looking at the phone through emails and tweets and all that more than I do. Okay. 75. Coffee that costs more than $2. Starbucks. You paying attention? 76. The last one. Okay, on this list that they have. People who take home milk from the communal fridge at work. Nope. Yeah. Why would you... If you have milk, like 2% whole milk, fat-free, whatever, in a fridge at work, why? Especially if a full gallon. Dude, are you living at work? That's my first thought. Yeah. Okay, that's that of this video. It's a very long one. I hope you enjoyed it. Even if you took multiple breaks from it. If you just were doing something and listening to this, cool. That's pretty much why I'm glad you did, okay? Leave me a like, subscribe if you haven't. I tend to don't upload many videos that are like more than 10 minutes long. So this is a very much rare occasion. Until next time, everyone, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell. Peace out, everyone.